Camera.
Questions.
Beautiful. So I'm going to subtitle this Solving Algebraic Equations. And I'm guessing that a lot of you did this, even maybe without using the notation that I'm going to use. Okay. So what I've said is, I know that the border of a square can be represented as the equation or the expression 4n minus 4. And this equals something. We could say 4n minus 4, this equals the size of my border. So I'm just going to use b. N was the number of squares on each side, and b is the total size of the border. So then I asked you, if I claim to have 210 bricks or squares in my border, can you tell me the number or the dimensions of that square? Or is this even possible? So here's kind of like the algebraic insight that might help you. 210 is actually equal to one of these variables. It's equal to b.
Okay.
So I can take 210 and I can put it in this equation where I had b. And that gives me something really special, which we haven't seen really a lot of yet this year, but this is an algebraic equation with one variable.
Mm-hmm.
And in general, if you have an algebraic equation, equation meaning you have an equal sign, and you have one variable, you can solve that, right? Now, sometimes you can solve these by kind of looking at them and thinking, I'm looking for a number where 4 times that number minus 4 is going to give me 210. So you can kind of reason through these. But there is another way to solve algebraic equations. Sometimes we call this like the golden rule of algebra. But the way that we can solve equations is this. You can do anything to one side of this equation as long as what?
You do it to the other side.
As long as you do the same to the other side. Right? So technically this is like a property of equality, which basically says if I add something to one side of the equation, I still have an equation as long as I add it to the other side. If I subtract, I still have an equation as long as I subtract. If I multiply, I still have an equation as long as I multiply. If I divide, if I take the square root, if I square it, if I add it to itself, I still have an equation as long as I do the same thing to the other side. And so with an equation that's kind of in this form, the way that I think about solving it is I kind of think of reversing PEMDAS. And there's a reason for this. My goal is to get the variable all alone here. I want to get n all by itself. I want to find out n equals some number. So in order to do that, I have to get rid of this 4 right here. I have to get rid of this 4 right here. But which one do I get rid of first? And why? Yeah, what do you think?
Well, you have to get rid of the one on the right, the negative 4, because that one is not touching the variable, and our goal is to isolate the variable. And if we do that first, then we still have a negative 4 that we have to deal with, so it makes more sense to get rid of the negative 4 first, and then get the variable, because then you're just done.
Totally. Yeah, so this is like, I would totally agree with everything Hazel just said. This is kind of like in our way, this minus 4. And so I want to get rid of that before I try to isolate my variable. Before I try to divide by 4, I want to get rid of this minus 4. I'm kind of like working my way in towards that end. It's not wrong to divide by 4 first. You can still do that. In fact, in this equation, it might even, in some ways, be better. But if you're not sure what to do, a good general strategy is to start at kind of the end of PEMDAS and go backwards. So in PEMDAS, I would do parentheses, exponents. I don't have any of those. Then I would do multiplication, division, addition, and then subtraction. So if I'm reversing that, I'm going to start by getting rid of my subtraction and then getting rid of my multiplication. But how do I get rid of a subtraction? How do I get rid of a minus 4? What do I need to do? So many hands. Yeah?
You'd add 4 to number 10.
Totally. And in this case, what I'm really doing is I'm adding 4 to both sides. Mm-hmm. So I'm trying to get rid of this minus 4, right? Because that's kind of reversing PEMDAS. I'm getting rid of that by adding 4. And so then I'm also going to add 4 to this side. So that gives me 4n is equal to 214. Does everyone see how I got this?
Yes.
Technically, there's like a plus 0 here because the negative 4 plus 4 is just 0.
Right.
Now what would I do? Well, now there's only one other thing in the way of the n, right? So I know exactly what I need to get rid of. I need to get rid of this 4.
Yeah.
How do I get rid of this 4? Yeah.
Right. Divide it by 4.
I'm going to divide both sides of this equation by 4. And I often write it like this. Kind of looks like a fraction, just because I like the feeling of those 4s canceling. Now, I don't know what 214 fourths is. I could certainly write this as a decimal. I would probably just, on the side of my paper, 214 and 4. I know that goes 5 times into 20.
Answer is 53.5.
This is kind of interesting. So 3 times 4 is 12. So now I need a decimal here.
Yep.
53.5. Okay, well, I don't really have any problem with decimals, but what's kind of strange about that given where we started?
It's a square and it has a decimal.
It's not
what am I, what did n represent?
Represented the number of squares on each.
The number of squares on each side. So if I were to try to draw this at the end, right, instead of having a full square at the end here, I would have to have like a half square.
Yeah, that's weird. That would make sense because then the next.
Yeah, just turn like this.
Then the height, like, kind of way across.
Right, so all, like, you could think of it as like all of these
are
kind of like halves, which, I mean, I guess that sort of makes sense.
Weird design choice, man.
Right, and then, so my first question, is this possible? I don't really quite know the answer to that, but I want you to think about that one, right? This algebraically, right, algebra is a tool. And algebra can be a really powerful tool for looking at a problem like this and coming up with a solution. We're saying 4n minus 4 equals 210. So can you then solve that equation to get me to an answer? Yeah.
Well, you can check your answer by doing
yes.
The equation by pulling in n div 53.5.
Yeah. Yeah, and I recommend always doing this. This is kind of the beauty of solving equations. You'll always know if you're wrong. So we did get an answer for n. The last step, though, I always like to check. And my check is, if I think that n equals 53.5, I should be able to take that, put it into my original equation, and see if it's still true. So is 4 times 53.5 minus 4 equal to 210. Is this true? How am I going to do that? Well, 4 times 53.5 is going to be first. Then subtract 4. I'm going to see if I get 2 times. So what is 4 times 53.5?
214.
214. I know 4 times 0.5 gives me a 2. That's a 12, so that gives me the 14. And 450s is 200. Cool. So 214 minus 4, does that equal 210?
Yeah.
Yeah, 210 does equal 210. So it checks. It does work. I didn't do anything wrong in solving the problem, and now I just have this big philosophical conundrum of if I want these little half bricks around the edge of my pool.
I mean, okay.
Before we go on, I do want to just do a little bit of practice solving equations. So we're going to kind of remove the context for a second. I'm just going to give you an equation. Let's solve it together. If I say 3x plus 7 is equal to 28, what's the first thing that you would do? First step. Willow?
Subtract 7 from both.
Totally. So I'm going to subtract 7 from both sides. And why did I do that?
So you could isolate the variable.
So I can get x all alone, so I can isolate the variable. Alright, so 3x plus 7 minus 7, what's left on this side of the equation?
3x.
3x. And then over here I have 28 minus 7, which is
21.
21. Alright, what would you do next? Juniper?
You would divide both sides by 3.
Totally. Yeah, and you can use the division symbol. I like to use this little fraction bar. 3 divided by 3 cancels out. What's 21 divided by 3?
7.
Am I done?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, technically, yes, but what should I do?
Check it.
How do I check it?
Plug it into the equation. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to take that answer, put it in here. 3 times 7 plus 7, does that equal 28?
Yes.
How do you know?
It's because 3 times 7 is 21, and 21 plus 7 is 28.
21 plus 7 is equal to 28. So it checks. And then I like to kind of circle or put my answer in a box at the end. X equals 7. Right? Let's do one more. What if I had something like this? Y over 5 minus 5 is equal to negative 3. All right, what do I do first here? What would you do first? Go ahead, Hazel.
Well, first you would add 5 to the negative 5 and then add 5 to the negative 13.
Okay, so I'm going to add 5 to both sides. Boom, cancels out. So y over 5 is equal to, what's negative 13 plus 5?
It would be
negative 8.
How do you know it's negative 8? Someone raise your hand and tell me. Yeah, Zaya.
Because when you are adding a positive number to a negative number, it is really just like subtracting.
It's just like subtracting, totally. And so 13 minus 5 is 8. Trying not to.
That's negative 8, right?
So wait,
it's just like subtracting, right?
So 13 what minus divided 5 by 5 would be 8, so that's 45.
Negative 8. That'd be negative 8.
Wait, why is this so negative
8? Is the answer 40? It's not negative.
Yeah, if you add 5.
It is negative 8. Because there's 1 negative.
Yeah, the answer is 40.
It's because the negative
40. Yeah, the answer is 40. Because what divided by 5 is 8? 40.
So I'm hearing a little discussion about this. I want to pause here before we try to find out what y equals. We're saying negative 13 plus 5 is negative 8, not 8.
Yeah.
Right.
So it's not quite just like subtraction.
It's addition for negatives.
Okay, it's like addition for negatives. How can I know if my answer is going to be positive or negative by looking at the two things I'm adding?
The negative number is bigger than the positive.
Yeah, my answer should always be kind of the same as the bigger. Okay, then I know we're out of time. Then I heard I'm going to multiply both sides times 5, so y equals negative 40. You could check that. We're out of time, so I'm going to stop the video there.